Hello everyone, out here mowing again. And look, I've got help.
Hi guys, I'm back.
She's back for today at least. She ain't gonna help me forever.
No, I can't.
She said she's tired of fooling me.
Tired of your bed.
Yeah, so we already got a bunch of leaves down here. Already starting to fall. So I'm gonna blow them out in the yard a little bit off the, well, there ain't much on the driveway. There's some right here though.
This one's yours.
Yeah.
How long
have I heard
that?
2.5 on that one. Get the leaves back in there, that way get mulched up a little bit better. So that's the reason why I did that. Which we won't get them all mulched up today, but we come to this one until December sometimes. Because they got all these trees around here, you can see around, and it just puts off a lot of leaves. And everybody seemed to blow into her yard.
Yeah.
Like the whole neighborhood puts their leaves here.
Honey, you're the best blower.
Well, thank you, honey. Appreciate it. Means a lot.
You know I love you.
Thank you.
Let me get the gate.
Thank you.
dusty back there. So even though we do this through the summer, we also do other stuff through the winter. What do you guys and gals do through the winter to compensate for not working because it's winter? As like us, we do snow plowing. Sometimes we'll build patios or barrier walls, whatever the customer needs. Sometimes we'll get snow, sometimes we won't. But what do you guys do through the winter months if you're out mowing? Let us know in the comments. You know, do y'all just take off for the winter and just kind of chill?
So that was really dusty back there. The leaves will make it dustier. Plus you got the dust from just being dry. What I was doing here was just trying to get it a little bit better looking. It still had a lot of leaves left even after we mulched the first time. So just ran over it again. We didn't expect to get all of them anyway. Like I said, we come here up to December usually. Still got leaves on it. This little festival going on down here. It used to be one of the largest in the state. I think it still is. It's over 100 some thousand people that come to it. It's called October 4 Days. But they also have one in Preston, Kentucky. They have this one in Mount Sterling, which is bigger. One in Preston is going on at the same time, and it's pretty big too. But yeah, it's like over 100 some thousand that come to that during the weekend. Kind of makes Mount Sterling the third largest city for a while for that weekend. As far as how many people are actually there. Third largest in Kentucky, I should say. But we're gonna drive past it in a second where we're going to next. So we'll kind of just show you, it's just now getting took off. It'll go through Monday. But we'll just kind of look off the viaduct, which is a bridge that goes above it, and give you a little bit of a view of it. Tracy loves it, you know, being a woman and all.
Oh, you gotta get that shopping in.
All right, we'll see you in a second. Get the barricades up.
Yeah. Saturday it'll be more packed.
Yeah, this is usually a lighter day.
Yeah. You can actually Google 4 Days of Mount Sterling to see what. what it originally started for. I'm not going to say it on here, but you can Google it. And then it just kind of turned into a
selling festival.
Yeah. And great the job. Food is so good down here. I mean, it is good. The sucky part is you got to eat while you're standing, but it's worth it. But if y'all ever get a chance, come to Mount Sterling Court Days. Usually we have people come from all around, all states. We even have people fly in from other countries just to come to it. But it's really good to see. And we'll take y'all to Preston too. That'll be fun. And y'all can see it.
Get a little clip of it.
Yeah, a little clip.
Probably won't be on this video though. It'll probably be on the next. Because we actually go on Saturday, and this video will come out probably Saturday.
Yeah.
So the next video will show you maybe just a little peek of each.
And the Preston one is more of a country setting. So you could buy chickens, goats, pigs, cows. I mean, dogs, coon dogs, any type of dog you want, really.
That's what this one kind of used to be. It just... Over time, they don't want to allow it anymore. I don't think they even allow to sell that kind of stuff here.
They don't allow you to set up a booth like they do in Preston for it. But a lot of people, they'll pull their animals in wagons that are for sale, like their pedigree dogs or whatever. And down here, you can buy, which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Well, you can buy pew-pews.
Can't say that. I'll believe it or something.
Yeah, you'll have to edit that out. You can buy pew-pews down here in the street. But yeah, it's pretty cool.
All right. Well, thanks for joining us, and we'll get off here. Go mow some more. Go get some meat.
Yeah.
I wish we could eat down there, but it's just too much ass. I'm trying to park this and get down long.
Yeah.
All that stuff. So we'll eat somewhere today. This weekend we'll get to eat down there.
Yeah, we'll get our fill down there for sure.
See you on the next one.
Bye, guys.
Bye.